Hi guys, it's MTG here, and the Note 8 is a brand new phone, and you may not know everything that it can do. Today I'm going to be going over some hidden features and tips and tricks that you may not have known about on the Samsung Galaxy Note 8. The first set of features that I'm going to be talking about today involved the Note 8's camera app. Like on the S8, you can quick launch the camera by double-clicking the power button. If this isn't on for you, you can go into Settings, Advanced Features, and toggle on Quick Launch Camera. Samsung has made some noticeable improvements in their camera user interface. The whole app was designed to be able to be operated with one hand. You can switch between cameras by simply swiping down or up. To access other camera modes like Pro and Panorama, swipe right, and to access the Live Filter, swipe left. Bixby Vision, Live Focus, and the Snapchat-style face tracking stickers can be found by clicking their respective words. To toggle between the wide-angle and telephoto lenses, click the X2 button. When you're in the telephoto lens, you'll still be able to couple this with a 10x digital zoom that you can do by sliding the shutter button right to zoom in and left to zoom out. When you're taking a picture, especially with one hand, the shutter button can be awkward to reach. To help combat this problem, Samsung added a floating shutter button feature that you can always have on. This button is movable and will always stay where you last put it. To turn this feature on, click the settings icon and scroll down to floating shutter. The next set of features that I'm going to be talking about today involve the included S Pen. On the Note 8, Samsung included this new feature called Live Message that allows you to create a GIF message using the S Pen and share it using just about any social media platform. You can access Live Message by pulling out the S Pen and clicking the Air Command icon. From here, simply write your message and click Share. What you may not have known is that you can access it directly from your keyboard. When you're in any messaging app, you'll be able to click the Live Message icon and send it directly to whoever you're currently messaging. The S Pen allows you to hover over menu icons in a desktop site to see the options available, and also allows you to click smaller on-screen buttons without fear of clicking the wrong one. Even when phones are becoming water-resistant, the screen becomes unresponsive and unusable when wet. But the S Pen allows you to interact with the screen even when it's wet, so you can use it by the pool or when it's raining or just about anywhere. The S Pen will also allow you to translate single words or complete sentences. Simply pull out the S Pen and click Translate. From here, you'll be able to select the language that you want to translate from. Then just hover over the word you want to translate and it will use Google Translate to translate what is written. To let it translate full sentences, click the T icon. Now we'll go through the complete sentence and translate it. The S Pen makes it easier than ever to capture the screen's content. If you pull out the S Pen and click the Air Command icon, you'll be able to select Smart Select. This will allow you to screenshot in the shape of the rectangle, oval, or a shape of your own. This will also allow you to make a GIF from any video playing on your phone. Simply click the GIF icon, play the video, and click record. Now you have a GIF in your gallery of the content you just recorded. When you need to jot something down quickly, the S Pen will also allow you to write screen off memos. Just pull the S Pen out and start writing. The last set of features that I'm going to be talking about today don't involve the camera or the S Pen, but I still think they're important to know. Samsung implemented a nice feature that helps utilize the big screen of the Note 8 called App Pairing. To use this feature, pull out the app's edge panel and click the plus icon. From here, press Create App Pair. In this case, I will choose the top app to be YouTube and the bottom app to be Twitter. Now, when you pull out the app's edge, you can open both apps at the same time and it will split the screen in half. Although Samsung has included a Bixby button on all their new phones, this is still an Android Nougat device, meaning that it has a Google Assistant built in. To access it, simply hold down the home button and speak when prompted. From the home screen, you can also say OK Google to activate the assistant. The last feature that I want to talk about today is the fact that the phone is equipped with 6GB of RAM. I thought the S8 Plus was smooth, but having the Note 8 for about a week now, it just doesn't stutter. I can have many apps open in the background and will continue to run smoothly. Multitasking is seamless and the general experience is great. So I will be definitely posting a lot of Note 8 content in the future, but I will also be posting a lot of iPhone 8 and iPhone 10 content, so make sure you click the logo down below to subscribe and click the notification bell to stay up to date with my latest videos. Check the description for a link to my Twitter account, and as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.